Calderas with their steep walls and large size are found at a wide range of volcanoes, having largely formed in very large explosive volcanic eruptions that eject 2 cubic kilometers or more of tephra. Such features can be found at a select group of stratovolcanoes such as the crater Lake Caldera in Oregon. Yet, some calderas do not form explosively, but rather effusively, as shown via the 2018 widening and deepening of Kilauea's caldera, which formed due to a large volume flank eruption. Yet, such effusively formed calderas are almost always found only at shield volcanoes. This is what makes the following volcano all the more unusual. As, in 2000, a stratovolcano off the coast of mainland Japan known as Miyakejima erupted, which, over the course of approximately a month and a half, formed a brand new caldera. This new caldera measured 1.6 kilometers wide and 330 meters or 1,082 feet deep, giving the volume of the caldera and thus the approximate amount of magma which seemingly vanished underneath it that caused the collapse to be around 0.64 cubic kilometers. And here lies the problem. Although the three-month-long eruption of Miyakejima did erupt explosively with a fairly sizable ash plume that occurred alongside pyroclastic flows, the amount of tephra the volcano ejected was a full order of magnitude lower than it should have been to form such a large caldera. As, despite this being incredibly rare, the caldera at Miyakejima did not primarily form due to an explosive eruption, but rather due to magma draining away from the volcano and going elsewhere in a process almost exclusive to some shield volcanoes. Before I explain why this unusual VEI-3 eruption occurred, I will discuss some basic facts about the volcano. Miyakejima is located approximately 180 kilometers south of Tokyo, where the volcano makes up the entirety of an island, which is part of the Izu island chain. Having an area of about 55 square kilometers and being 9.4 kilometers long, approximately 2,500 people live on its landmass. Like other volcanoes in the Izu island chain, Miyakejima exists due to a tectonic plate collision to the east. There, the Pacific plate is subducting underneath the Philippine Sea plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards until it reaches the surface and erupts, forming a chain of volcanoes. For much of the last 500 years, Miyakejima produced a moderate to highly explosive eruption about once every 50 years. That was until June 26th of 2000, when an earthquake swarm underneath the summit of the Miyakejima volcano occurred. Over the next few hours, these quakes slowly migrated away from the summit until they began occurring further and further away from the volcano in the ocean to the west of the island. Then, on June 27th, a swarm of earthquakes involving 21 magnitude 4 quakes struck a few kilometers west of the island. Clearly, something unusual was occurring, and we now know that these quakes marked the movement of magma, which triggered a fairly brief submarine eruption that created patches of discolored water on the same day. That submarine eruption ended, but after a week, seismic activity began increasing again, with a large cluster once again occurring progressively further west of the island, continuing to move in that direction. Then, beginning in mid-July, the summit region of the volcano began subsiding, indicating that a new caldera was starting to form. We now know that this caldera collapse was triggered not by the submarine eruption which occurred, but rather by at least 2/3 of a cubic kilometer of magma draining away from the volcano due to a formation of a 33-kilometer long dike. As magma moved underneath the ocean surface and did not erupt, additional earthquakes were created, generating the abundant observed earthquakes. As shown by the number of large mar explosion craters around Miyakejima, which measure up to 1,200 meters wide, this volcano has produced 6 VEI-4 eruptions in the last 10,000 years. However, these explosive eruptions are generally thought of as too small to have formed the two calderas known to have formed on this volcanic island before its 2000 caldera in the last 100,000 years. Thus, it is quite possible that although they may have formed in explosive eruptions, a similar subsurface dike like what was just witnessed in 2000 may have instead formed these older calderas. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.